I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. And all my days I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest night you were close like no other. I've known you as a father, and I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. Yeah! 'Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause your goodness is running after, it's running after me. 'Cause your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now, and I'll give you everything. 'Cause your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now, I'll give you everything. 'Cause your goodness is running after, it keeps running after me. Cause all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. And with every breath that I am able, oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I'm gonna sing of the goodness of God.
Welcome to our Sunday online service. I'm Jen Melkai, and we're thrilled that you've joined us today. If you are new to Trinity, text WELCOME to 262-302-3021. I will be in contact with you, and Trinity will donate $5 to the charity that you choose. You can also text GROUP to that same number to join one of our small groups. It's your absolute last chance to sign up for the lasagna fundraiser. Cutoff is noon today, Sunday. I just made things a lot easier for my husband by ordering mine. If you want to support the Kenya Classroom Project, please give through Trinity, but on the memo, please make that to Kenya Missions. Remember, Pastor Brian said our goal is to reach $7,500 for our council to match it. If you really want to help out our ministry, please consider gifting online. We wouldn't be here without your generous support. And as you know, we always celebrate the 20th online giver, and this week it's dun-dun-da-da! Congratulations. How dads of Kenya motivate their kids. Kenya do this? Get it? Kenya? K-E-N-Y-A? As we prepare for worship, please make sure you have some bread and some wine or juice so that we may celebrate Holy Communion together. Today, Pastor Brian is at a mission congregation called Jordan Lutheran Church near Monroe, Wisconsin. He wanted you to know that today is a special day for Trinity. As we celebrate Trinity's 74th anniversary today, we are reminded that during these past 40 years, we have raised up over 10 pastors, supported 7 missionaries, developed 15 youth leaders, and made hundreds of disciples. We instigated the formation of Teens Encounter Christ in Wisconsin and Sunrise Via de Cristo, as well as our new Revive spiritual retreats. 15 years ago, Joyce Rawson was a regular worshiper at Trinity who had just completed the 18-month Bethel Bible series. She knew that as a Bethel graduate, she was expected to serve in some ministry for 1 year. So she began providing professional counseling each week for several hours. As the years progressed, she found caregiving ministry to be so fulfilling that she felt called to become a full-time pastor with an emphasis in counseling. Today, we celebrate the 10th anniversary of Pastor Joyce's ordination. She has been a blessing to Trinity, offering thousands of hours of counseling, caregiving, and peacemaking within the Trinity Church community. She has helped make our congregation a spiritual hospital in which people develop a positive, life-changing connection with Jesus Christ. Pastor Joyce, we would like to give this plaque to you as a reminder of this wonderful milestone. Thank you. God bless you. Today we celebrate as we begin in the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen. We love you, Lord, and can't help but sing to you.
With all your strength, love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength, with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your strength. I will serve the Lord with all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind, with all my strength. I will serve the Lord with all my heart, with all my soul, with all my mind, with all my strength. With all my heart, with all my soul. With all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, with all your
Let us share our faith as written in the Apostles' Creed.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Trinity Church believes in prayer. And we believe in miracles. Let's listen to our scripture today where Jesus feeds the 5,000.
Our scripture reading today comes from the book of Matthew, chapter 14, verses 13 through 21. Jesus feeds the 5,000. When Jesus heard the news about John, he left there in a boat and went to a lonely place by himself. The people heard about it, and so they left their homes and followed him by land. Jesus got out of the boat, and when he saw the large crowd, his heart was filled with pity for them, and he healed their sick. That evening, his disciples came to him and said, "It is already very late, and this is a lonely place. Send the people away. Let them go to the villages to buy food for themselves." "They don't have to leave," answered Jesus. "You yourselves give them something to eat." "All we have here are 5 loaves and 2 fish, they replied. "Then bring them here to me," Jesus said. He ordered the people to sit down on the grass. Then he took the 5 loaves and the 2 fish. He looked up to heaven and gave thanks to God. He broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the people. Everyone ate and had enough. Then the disciples took up 12 baskets full of what was left over. The number of men who ate was about 5,000, not counting the women and children. This is the word of the Lord.
Wow, that was a miracle. How can we not praise our God for his awesome wonder? We sing praise to the Lord.
Praise to the Thank you.
have the great honor and privilege to introduce you to our missionaries from Kenya. When you realize that Holly grew up at Trinity Church and became the director of children's ministry, you know that we have been impressed by her character and calling. She completed the Bethel Bible class and participated in Teens Encounter Christ. She also worked at Covenant Harbor as a counselor. She spent more than a year with YWAM in Africa and later completed her degree in social work. While serving in Kenya, she met Fred and eventually they married. Now they work together for the good of God and for Good News Kenya. Fred is the pastor and Holly the director of the new school that they have begun. Fred and Holly will tell us about their God-honoring efforts today.
Good morning, Trinity Church. What an honor to be with you again this morning. My name is Pastor Fred Okoth. I serve in Kenya with my wife, Holly. We have two children, Lucy, who is 14, and Eliana, who is 6 years old. We've been serving with Good News Kenya for the last 8 years. I pastor a church. Holly oversees our sponsorship program of 75 children. And together, we direct Good News Migwena Academy. Few months ago, we started to communicate with Pastor Brian about our visit to Trinity. At that time, we never expected that our family would have such a great testimony about how God has answered our prayer by healing us from COVID-19, making us strong enough to travel, departing our hometown hours before it was in a lockdown due to a bad third wave, and being with you here today, this morning, is a miracle and it is a great testimony. Indeed, our God is a good God. Just 2 months ago, our entire family was diagnosed with COVID-19. It was scary, and I had to remember that indeed our God was good, as all of our plans to come to the U.S. were temporarily canceled. We didn't know if we would be able to travel in 2 weeks or 2 months. We had big plans for our trip home, and now we are quarantined. What an inconvenience! How is God answering our prayer?
As we started to quarantine and manage our symptoms from home, I started to have trouble breathing. Fred rushed me to the hospital, and as soon as I reached the hospital, I was put on oxygen. In this moment, it is so easy to have your mind filled with fear and negative thoughts. As we became more and more concerned in the ER as to whether the hospital would have enough room to admit me, we turned to worship music to help turn our focus back to our good God. We played this song over and over that you might know. It is called The Goodness of God, and it has powerful lyrics.
All my life you have been faithful. All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. As our family was diagnosed with COVID-19, God gave me peace in my heart that we would be healed. And despite this setback that my wife, Holly, is on oxygen, I grabbed hold of God's assurance that he was going to heal us, all of us. As my wife and I were together, our negative thoughts and fears started to be replaced with God's promises, with God's faithfulness in our lives over many, many years. We were reminded of how God has enabled us to serve him as a family without lacking anything for 8 years. How God provided and healed Eliana from clubfoot, a birth defect that she was born with. How God has blessed us with our two daughters, Eliana, for which we prayed for several years, and Lucy's adoption approval. How I received my visa approval after trying or after being denied 6 times. How God expanded Good News Kenya over the years. How God has never let us in the valley and in the mountains. His presence and peace has been with us always. What a good, good God. Focusing on faithfulness of God gave us strength to trust that God was with us, that we can all call on Him in our times of trouble, and He lovingly embraces us. Thank you for praying for our family Trinity when we were sick. It is a testimony that we can all be here today with you. We give all the glory to our Almighty God. Of course, we still have several prayer items today as we go before God. We pray that God will continue to expand Good News Kenya. We pray for our future provision, prayers for growth in our family, prayers for healing for our friends and family. We don't know when and how God will answer these prayers. But as we are all in this journey, as we pray, we trust our God is always faithful. Always.
Have you ever had a prayer that you prayed for several years? A dream that you really desired? As many of you know, before I moved to Kenya, I worked at Trinity Church as a youth director. I really loved my job. I had an office to the right of the building, and at my office, I had big blueprints of an orphanage that I wanted to build one day in Kenya. So when I moved to Kenya in 2012, it was my desire and my dream to one day have that orphanage. It was something I thought about often. I told my family and friends. I might have even told several of you. I had prayed this prayer for over 10 years. So when I moved to Kenya and I found out that our directors had the same dream, vision, and prayer, we knew it was something that God was calling us to do. We believed that God was with us. After serving in Kenya for 6 years, we were finally about to receive a $25,000 donation to help us start this orphanage. At first, we were so excited about this donation, we were finally able to move forward on this big prayer that we had. However, as the time went by and as we were getting closer to receive this donation, our hearts became troubled. We started to look around us, in our community, and within our sponsorship program. We had many children in our sponsorship program that had one parent alive, and a few that had no parents. But all of the children in our sponsorship program, they at least had one parent alive or a relative that would raise them. However, today, if we opened an orphanage, almost all of these parents and guardians would bring their child to our orphanage for that they would have a chance to be educated and to be fed daily. The parent is willing to make this sacrifice to help break the chain of poverty in their family. It breaks our heart that many parents feel like this is a decision that has to be made. I'll never forget one day we were doing admission interviews for our sponsorship program. We were interviewing 4-year-old Jackie and her mom. Jackie's mom was mentally challenged and she was also HIV positive. We had asked Jackie's mom several questions about Jackie's upbringing. What does Jackie like? What does she not like? What does Jackie want to be when she grows up? At the end of the interview, Jackie's mom said quietly to us, "Please don't take Jackie away from me." Fred and I, we made eye contact as our hearts melted. This seems like such an awkward question to ask, but Jackie's mom has heard of the many orphanages around the country that indeed take children away from families. 4 out of 5 children in orphanages today have at least one parent alive. As Fred and I made eye contact and our hearts broken, we assured Jackie's mom that we did not want to remove Jackie from her family. But as good news, Kenya, that we wanted to come alongside Jackie's mom to help educate her and provide for some of her basic needs. Jackie's mom was so relieved. She had peace that she could ensure that her child was educated and could remain at home. Similar situations like this, they started to have an impact on our big dream and vision of having that orphanage. Is an orphanage really what the community needs? Is this best for children and families? We have been praying for so many years that God would make this come to pass. But is God in this? Is this the heart of God? Is this God's will? As God changed our hearts and vision, we went to our directors, and together we prayed and we talked and we agreed that maybe God is not calling us to build an orphanage. It was so hard for us to let go of something that we had wanted and prayed for so long. But ultimately, we wanted to be obedient to what God was asking us to do. As we prayed, as we were quiet, as we listened, God imprinted on our hearts that the best way to help the community is to come alongside these families by providing quality, affordable, and Christian education, all while these children remain at home with their families, being supported by Christian values and teachings. So, in January 2020, we opened Good News Migwena Academy. In January 2020, we decided as a ministry that we wanted to preserve families, that we wanted to invest in Kenya's next generation by giving them the very best that they deserved, family and an education, and not having to choose just one. When you support Good News Migwena Academy, you aren't only helping us build a classroom or provide a desk for a student, but you are supporting a family. And when you support a student, you are supporting a child staying with their family. This is the heart of God, and this is now the heart of Good News Kenya. God changed our prayer, and then he changed our heart. And as he changed our prayer, he ultimately answered our prayer, and he blessed his work. Today, Good News Migwena Academy is a pillar of hope in Migwena Village. Good News Academy is growing faster than we ever expected. This rural community is also saying that God has answered their prayer by providing quality, affordable, and Christian education in a place where there was previously none. Even though changing our vision from an orphanage to a Christian school was a huge inconvenience, we were able to see God at work.
As we look at today's scripture of Jesus Christ feeding 5,000, this is a story that we all know. We have grown up hearing this in Sunday school, and it is one of the popular miracles that Jesus performed. As the disciples saw a huge crowd of people, their first reaction was that this was an inconvenience. The disciples were filled with fear on how they are going to feed this huge crowd of people with 2 fish and 5 loaves of bread. Their first reaction was to send these people away. However, Jesus Christ challenged them by saying, "Let them come. Let them come." Jesus had bigger plans, yet his disciples were not able to see that. As we look back to when we were diagnosed with COVID-19. It went from an inconvenience to a truly frightening time. As we look back, when our daughter was born with club feet, our hearts broke and we were overwhelmed with fear. As we look to our original vision to have an orphanage, God started to change our hearts. Just as Jesus changed the heart of this disciple that day. And as the disciples started to turn their fears into faith in God, they were able to see the miracle of God and the great provision of God for his people. If you were never sick with COVID-19, we wouldn't have been able to have the opportunity of God's healing us and also comforting our hearts. If our daughter wasn't born with club feet, then we wouldn't have been here today giving this great testimony of how God healed her and also provided for her surgery. When an inconvenience and seasons of deep pain and brokenness come into our lives, we are learning to let our first reaction to be looking upon God through prayer. To reach out to God in prayer is to trust He is right here with us in the challenge that we are facing. And like the 5,000 gathered, He's waiting to feed us with what we need in a way we may yet not even able to comprehend.
Remember 4-year-old Jackie? She is now almost 7 years old, and she's still part of our ministry. In fact, Jackie was one of the first class of students to attend Good News Migwena Academy. However, in November 2020, Jackie's mom tragically passed away. And a few weeks before she had joined the academy, her father also passed away. We remembered Jackie's mom's original request that she would remain in her loving family. How could we continue to keep this promise now that both of her parents are gone? Especially now that Jackie truly is an orphan and we did not build an orphanage. And so we prayed. And we praise God that He provided an aunt who is willing to take Jackie into her home. And this aunt was able to do this in large part because of the support that our school and ministry is able to provide Jackie and her. Not just tangible support like food, but Jackie's aunt knows that she will not be alone in raising Jackie. She has a loving teacher. She has a classroom full of friends, and they both have a community that surrounds them both with the love of God. Jackie's story is just another example of God feeding the thousands with a few loaves and a couple fish. And it is a vision that God has given Good News Kenya to expand this hope by making more room in our school to provide this same opportunity for many more Jackies. We are so thankful that Trinity is helping us expand this hope by adding another classroom. You are helping us reach more Jackies so that they can have a positive, life-changing connection with Jesus Christ.
Like the disciples, God's vision can be scary. It is for us. But thanks be to God, as we look back on the lessons we have learned, both in our family and in our ministry, we are not called to understand. We are called to be faithful. Why? Because, as the song reminds us, all my life you have been faithful.
All my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. Amen.
Jambo, welcome to Good News Migwena Academy.
My name is Holly Okoth. Welcome to Good News Migwena Academy. I'm a missionary with Good News Kenya, and we started this school in January 2020 with only 20 students. A year later, we have over 65 students in three grade levels. We look forward to adding on 8 classrooms behind us, as well as an early childhood developmental education center in the corner over there. This school is a pillar of hope in this community. Migwena Village did not previously have a private school that had the resources of teaching these children with the tools that they deserve. We're able to give them the resources to expand their creativity, to ignite their imagination, and to make a difference in this village. We hope that you will partner with us.
My name is Milka Nekesa, the school manager. Our vision is to nurture knowledge, wisdom, talent, and faith. In the aspects of faith, we want our children to understand, to know more about God, and to be role model outside there in the community. We want them to grow, to be like Christ. So we have a theme each term, and this time we are focusing on the theme about the fruits of the Holy Spirit. And our kids love it very much. They want to know the attributes of God. They want to know who God is. And each and every time we'll want them to know and understand the characters of God. Amen.
My name is Pastor Fred Okoth. I am the director of Good News Academy. Growing up in Kenya, I know firsthand the challenge it is to find a quality and affordable education in a rural setup. As the director, I am proudly saying that Good News Academy gives parents the assurance that their child will get the best they deserve. My prayer that you will consider standing with us to help us begin the second phase in May 2021. Our phase two goal is $40,000, and it will add the 3 nursery classrooms, teacher's office, and expand our playground and provide learning resources. Take a step of faith with us and let us join hands across the world as we make a difference in Migwena Village in Jesus' name. Amen.
We remember Jesus' words, "Blessed are those who have not seen but believe." That's all of us. What an awesome testimony we are to others when we share that faith. Just like the disciples that were gathered with him were soon going to share their faith with others. And on that last night, he took the bread, and after giving thanks, he broke it. And he gave it to them saying, "Take and eat. This is my body. This is given for you. Remember me." In the same way, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he blessed it, and he gave it to them, saying, "Take and drink. This cup is the new covenant in my blood. It is shed for you for the forgiveness of your sins. As many times as you eat of this bread and drink from this cup, remember my sacrifice for you. And now we remember Jesus and his sacrifice by saying the prayer that he taught us, lifting our hands in submission. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. And now, if you would take your communion kits and remove the wafer from it. And again, listen to Jesus' words. Take and eat. This is my body. This is given for you. And again, his words, after you take the cup. Listen, he said, take and drink. This cup is the new covenant in my blood. It is shed for you for the forgiveness of your sins. And now may the Lord's body and his blood strengthen you and keep you in his grace until we all will meet him someday face to face.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him, all creatures here below. Praise him above, ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen.
May the Lord bless you this week as you experiment with asking. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face to shine on you and be gracious unto you. The Lord look upon you with his favor and give you his peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you fully trusting in his grace this hour? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed?
Are you washed
in the blood?
In the blood,
in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Lay aside the garments that are stained with sin and be washed in the blood of the Lamb. There's a fountain flowing for the soul unclean. Oh, be washed in the blood of the Lamb. Are you washed?
Are you washed
in the blood?
In the blood,
in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb. Are your garments spotless? Are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Some glad morning when this life is over, I'll fly away to a home on God's celestial shore. I'll fly away. I'll fly away. Just a few more weary days and then I'll fly away to a land where joy shall never end. I'll fly away. I'll fly away. Oh, glory. I'll fly away. When I die, hallelujah, by and by, I'll fly away.
as you go in peace, what is our mission? To help my neighbor make a positive, life-changing connection with Jesus Christ. God bless you all.